You know how powerful it is when you share what God has done for you. So we're going to give the mic to you guys to share what God has done for you. Who wants to go first? Because I'll pick you. No one did anything for God this weekend. God didn't do anything for you, Josiah.
Was it you up here?
Stronger and it shows people how I feel.
So I've come here, and I don't really know God a lot. I want to get to know Him a lot better. It's hard to be angry at somebody who you don't know. But I was angry at God, and I didn't know it. And I didn't want to believe that it was true. But it was. So I want to say right now, God, I forgive you. And everyone who's hurt me, I forgive you. I forgive you, Scarlett, for hurting me. For hurting our family. And I forgive you, everyone who's ever hurt me in the past, who I've pulled grudges against but never been told. And I want to let everyone know that I don't want to hold my emotions anymore. I want to be strong. I want to rise up. I want to let God in. And I don't want to be the same when I have no hope. So I just want to change all of that.
Who's going to help? you, but this is just my favorite. Because you've actually been out.
How many?
Half.
So, my life, I grew up believing I was a failure. I've always known what it's like to be at rock bottom. I have been as close to the streets as possible, and I've come a long way from that, but I've also had a lot of anger and hostility to the world because of it. And this weekend, I let a lot of that go. I never knew what it's like to have someone actually love me because my family makes it possible. I am always fighting my brother, always getting arguments with my mom. I don't ever have a place to be peaceful. But this weekend, I feel like I've lived.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't, it was not fake. This weekend was a blast, and I loved it. Because of people like Greg, and Kyle, and Donovan, and Patrick Frank, who have stuck by my side through all of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I thank all of them.
I was really, ugly. I hated the world and I hated everyone. But God really changed me in that way and made me the opposite of that. So, yeah.
Amen. Beautiful. I don't know what you got you, but there's a deep pain within you that God's going to heal. And you see yourself in a way where it took away from your beauty, from your self-confidence. It just started stealing from you. But God's going to turn all that around. Because look at what you're doing again. Kylie, you need to see yourself as a beautiful young lady. A young lady that has a tremendous love, a tremendous amount of love from the Father in heaven. And I don't know what this means, but I see a relationship between really you and your mom that God's going to even make you even stronger and better. That has to happen. And God's going to do it for you. He loves you. God loves you so much. You're going to see him move in such a way that not only are you beautiful, God, but you're also going to be a leader. You're going to be a leader. So go on that pain that's there. God's going to start to heal that and watch and see what happens. And also, don't be surprised when people are going to start coming to you. But now you're going to be able to give to them what God has given to you. Okay? God loves you. God bless you so much. God bless you.
Thank you.
connection with people. I lack connection with myself. I lack connection with God. For years, I have been going to the church, but I've only been going to just a church, because that's all I see it as, a church. I saw nothing special in it. I just said, well, might as well go to church. I go to church. I sort of think that's maybe how I'll get close to God, just by going to church, that my life is going to be perfect, that my life is going to just be blessed all the time, just because I go to church once a week, if not maybe once a month. I struggle a lot with myself, with trying to be nice to others who are so nice to me. I like to make friends with terrible, terrible people and do terrible things that I am not supposed to be doing, but I do it anyways because it's the only way that I feel so good about myself. Because in that moment, I don't think about myself at all, I don't think about others. All I can think about is all I can disappear from the world and just. Every time I get invited to go to youth retreats, I go. I pray, I cry my heart out, begging for forgiveness, throwing it all in, begging for my anxiety to go away, begging for my depression to go away, begging that I don't feel the way that I do anymore, begging for myself to be nice and to be kind, to be loving. But as soon as I leave that place, I go back to her, the cycle of being rude, of being vicious, of being ruthless, and going back to hurting people. It's repetitive, and I'm tired of it. But it feels like that's the only thing that I want to do, and it's tiring, it makes me sick. And these past couple months have been the hardest because my depression has been hitting me like a train over and over and over again, and I just can't seem to get away from it. I had a nice relationship with my brother, but I ruined that accepted it. I accepted it. It made me dizzy. It made me want to go back to sleep. It made me want to avoid the rest of the night. But I did it. Yesterday when I was at the altar, when they asked us to pour our heart out, to ask God for forgiveness, to give him our all, I did not want to. I wanted to hold on to that depression. I wanted to hold on to anxiety because that's all I've known for years. And it's time consuming. It is exhausting. I never want my own brother to go through it. I never want my parents to go through it. I don't want any other person to go through it. I don't want any young girls to go through it because they have no idea how time-consuming it can be if you depend on it all the time. It makes you go crazy. It makes you think about things that you should not be thinking about. It makes you selfish. It makes you lack character. It makes you stray away from God for months. It makes you hate the entire world. It makes you hate people you should love. But then when it comes to anxiety, you start freaking out so much, saying, oh no, I shouldn't be acting like this because people are going to hate me. I shouldn't push people away because maybe they're going to hate me. I shouldn't push my parents away because they're going to stop loving me if I keep acting the way they do. And it took me a long, long time to get my parents to love me the right way because of the way I've been acting for months. I have cousins who are like my sisters. I push them away because I hated how nice they were. I hated how everyone loved them because of how nice and social they were. I hated one of my cousins who recently got married. I hated her most for so long because she was lovable and because she had perfect relationships that I wanted.
Bless you.
But I shouldn't take this for what I don't have. I've been hanging out with them for months now. And they have been influencing me to be the best person that I can be. Because I lack love for my sister. Because I am the only daughter of my mother. I have always wanted a sister, and I gained two sisters despite the fact that I lost one. And because of that, I have learned my lessons in many, many things. I have learned to be more approachable, I guess. To be more loving, to be more kind, despite the fact that I get very, very annoyed very easily. You know. Last night was an experience for me. It was a lot more different than when I had Bobby as a youth pastor, from when I had Daylen as my youth pastor, from when I met Greg. My experiences have been a lot different. This is nothing compared to anything else I've experienced. I received three different messages from three different pastors, which I still don't understand, that I'm still trying to figure out what they mean. I'm still trying to figure things out as I go. And if I'm stuck, then I'm going to pray, God, and ask him, please just guide me, please just lead me to the right direction. Don't lead me down the wrong path. Because I'm terrified. I'm absolutely terrified of the unknown.
and 19. You're going to be unstuck today. I see at a young age, 11, maybe 12 years old, there was a tremendous amount of betrayal. And you've experienced that over and over and over and over again. And if I say anything that's not true, you tell me. But I believe the Lord is speaking to you right now. And that betrayal has kept you at the place where it has, to protect yourself, you pushed everyone away because of the fear of being let down again, being betrayed again. But God's going to change that today. He's going to change that today. By the way, you can go to college.
Amen.
You're destined to college. But there's a tremendous big call in your life that the Lord has. You're going to be a tremendous instrument in the marketplace. Not necessarily within the church, but in the marketplace. But God wants you to heal that betrayal. And this is what we're going to do, and I want you to repeat after me, okay?
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
I come before you. And I place before you.
And I place before you.
Every person.
Every person.
That has betrayed me.
That has betrayed me.
That has let me down.
That has let me down.
That spoke against me.
That spoke against me.
That never came through.
And never came through.
And this morning.
And this morning.
I forgive
them. I forgive.
I forgive them.
Yes. Happen in your life, and I know this from experience because it happened.
It's going to ripple out and you have no idea who it's going to touch. It may touch your family, it may touch someone else, but it'll ripple out and you'll touch people. So let the power of God shift things.
Anyone else? Hannah? Here's what we do. Is there anyone else who has besides Hannah for one sentence? Katie? Okay. A couple more, and then I'm going to read one scripture to you guys. One you all know. And it's not that you're essentially training, they don't have it. They don't have pastors there.
I used to not believe in any of this, like a couple years ago. Then I moved up here and I met people and it changed my life. But most of my life I hated myself, like everything about me, because since I can remember, I've been bullied as long as I can remember, and I've gone through.
Thank you. from the school courtyard to the, what I see from the school courtyard, you know, most of the people follow the people they hide, even in the church. And it's the kids in there too, because I remember my family kind of forced me to go to church. I didn't want to be there. But just seeing these little kids come, you know, little children of God, just warms my heart. And I feel like God purpose, he has a straight purpose in life. Just hold on and hold their hands along the whole way. That's pretty much what I got out of this week. I just appreciate kids from my youth because I know they get it. I know they get it.
That's what's cool about this group is everybody gets it. Everybody gets it. And when you get it, our job is so easy. Okay. You get Pastor Sam when you read one scripture and Ty's got a lot when I read it. Probably Katie too. Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to him, "Rulers and elders of our people, are we being questioned today because we've done a big deed for a crippled man? You want to know how he was healed? Let me clearly state to all of you and to all the people of Israel that he was healed by the powerful name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene. Everything that you left, everything that you were touched was done by Jesus Christ. I mean, you guys, there are people their whole life, older than me, who have never experienced what you experienced the last 3 days. And they want it, they want it, they want it, and they don't know how to get it for you because they don't want to let go. You guys know how to let go. I'm getting on a rabbit trail over here. These guys know what my rabbit trail is. There is no salvation in anyone else. No salvation in anyone else but Jesus. He's the only way to heaven. The members of the council were amazed, and this is the part I want you to get. The members of the council were amazed, guys. When they saw the boldness of Peter and John, for they could see that they were not ordinary men with no special training in scriptures. Are you an ordinary man? Have you had a lot of training in scriptures? So you're a lot like Peter and John. When you go back to school, allow people to recognize that you've been with them. Because when they see that you have been with Jesus, you don't have to open your mouth. You don't have to talk a big story. They just know. And that will radiate to them what's different about Josiah. He's been with Jesus. What's different about faith? She's been with Jesus. You don't have to be real smart. You don't have to know all about this book. You just have to let people recognize that you have been with Jesus. Pastor Sam. Oh. Who's going to show people tomorrow that they have been with Jesus? Don't hide it under a bushel. That might be a turn off the light for a minute. That's right. Do you guys like what you're doing here today? Do you guys like what you had here this weekend? Do you know what you had here this weekend? You from out there. And that's not true. because you guys can feel it here in this place. What I'm going to do is I'm going to challenge you to take that flow and keep that flow. Don't stop it. Don't let the world stop it. You keep that flow and you pour it out to the rest of the world. That's what you're called to do. That's what we're all called to do. You take what you got today, this weekend, you take that flow and you let it go. Don't stop it because it's not cool. Don't stop it because people say, what's wrong with you? You have nothing wrong with you. This weekend, you've experienced what it's like to have nothing wrong with you. Absolutely nothing wrong with you. Keep that. Take it home. Take it to school. And take it through the rest of your lives. And you will see changes that you never thought of. If you want something to change in your world, where you live, where you go to school, if you want something to change, you keep that flow and it will. I'm here to testify right now, it will. I've seen it. So don't let the world stop you. Don't let the world stop this.
Well, guys, I just wanted to say how proud I am of each and every one of you in this room. Listen, every single person in this room is an overcomer. You have all overcome the odds that the devil has set aside to take you out. You've all accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior. Listen, you need to understand the authority that you carry in Jesus Christ. You're not below the devil. The devil is below you. Remember the scripture says that he put the serpent under Adam's feet in the garden. The devil sits below you. He has fallen from his place in glory. You stand at the right hand of the Father. Next to Jesus Christ is your brother and sister. You are our brothers and sisters. You are the most important thing in this world. You are. It's not them. It's you. You are going to make the difference. Take what you have. Take what you got this weekend. Put it to use. Listen, when you get sick and you get an infection, one cell changes another, which changes another, which changes another, and it begins to grow, and begins to grow, and begins to grow. You are the one cell in your school. If you change one person, and then you work together to change somebody else, you will begin to grow. And you will see an impact that is made larger than you've ever seen in anything. Listen, we can stay up here all day, all weekend, all night, all year, all month. We can preach to you, we can talk to you, we can tell you anything. But unless you understand who you are, nothing happens. Nothing happens. Understand who you are. I see beautiful people. Listen, you're not ugly. I love your girls.
I do too.
I absolutely love them. My son has girls. I love my son. Listen. This girl right here. You. One. You remind me of my daughter. My daughter was here this weekend. She dealt with issues that she had felt in her life. She's a beautiful woman. And she sings. And listen, I can't say anything to you. I feel emotion. I can feel everything that everybody's going through in this room. It's a perfect gift. God gave that to you so that you can do something with it. Listen, if you need love, this girl right here. I'm not even joking. Not even joking. She has more than enough to give. This man right here 30 plus years, in, I don't know where it's going, have poured their lives out into me. Poured their lives out. Because God called them. And he still to this day pours into you. Why? Because he loves you. He loves your generation enough to do it repetitively here and here. These intercessors over here love you. They would not do the tea room and pray for you and intercede for you if they did not love you. But they see something in you that you have not seen in yourselves. Gabby, I love you. I've watched you for the last 3 years grow. And then today, are free.
Amen.
Listen, don't let the devil lie to you, huh? You're free. You do not have to do the things that you used to do. As of this day forward, you are a new creation, a perfect and holy gift. Accept it. The Holy Spirit is not just a small little thing that you receive. It is one of the largest things that you receive that Jesus Christ gave to the disciples after he left and ascended out of heaven. He said in Acts chapter 2, I give you the Comforter. Listen, when you're feeling down and you can't explain why you're feeling the way you are, ask for him to help you. He lives in you. He lives in you. I grew up in a bad neighborhood with bad people and it is bad things. I didn't have anything. I didn't have anyone. But you know what? When I gave my heart to the Lord, he changed me. That's why I stand here today. That's why I'm a pastor. Because God called me. Listen, he's calling me. He's calling me. Just like he called all of us. He's calling me. We invest in you. Why? Because if we invest in you and you change now, we don't have to change the adults. Because you are going to be the adults. And then you will be working with the other kids. Right? God has purpose. His plan is far beyond what we can even imagine. And he wants to do it for you. I will do this 1,000 times.
Amen.
1,000 times. I will do this exactly. I will pour my heart out. I will do everything it takes to reach you. Whatever it takes. Listen, if you're going through something and you need help, call me. Call Pastor Graham. Don't think that you're alone, because you're not. Some of you in this room know me well. I pretty much got the thing. But God has a purpose, and it's for you. It's for you. And he's going to make himself perfect exactly. Father, I thank you for this weekend, Lord. I thank you for these kids. I thank you for the heart of these kids, Lord. They have gone out and purposely, Father, raised the funds to pay for this camp. Father, that we might be able to bring people on. Father, that we might be able to have people here. And Lord, no matter what the cost, Father God, because if Jesus is willing to lay down his life for us, we should be willing to lay down our life for our brothers. And Father, I just thank you right now, Lord, that you have touched every single heart in this room. You have developed friendship in this room, Father God. We are not going to go home the same. We have going home today, Lord, change. And Father, as you change this world, Father, we are the new generation, Father God. We are, as Jake Hamilton singing this song, this is our anthem. Father, we just thank you right now, Father God, that you have changed us to change the world. Father, we just want to bless you, we want to thank you, we want to praise you, Father God, for everything that you've done. Father, for bringing Encounter AC up here to minister to us, Father God. The words that they gave, the songs that they sang, Father God. Lord, even the songs that Kai and the team sang for us today, Father God. You have put those in people's minds and hearts, Father God, to give us an opportunity to sing back to you, to give that emotion, Father God. Lord, so that we can have a one-on-one conversation with you. Sitting in the Father's lap. Lord, we just thank you. We glorify you. And Father, I just ask that you bless everybody in here today. Father, as they travel home, Lord, put your glory and you put your mercy upon them. Father, let your spirit just begin to flow and fall like rain upon their hearts, upon their minds. Father, because we are changed from this day forward. Father, there's a relationship that is established here in unity of bodies, Father, between many churches, Father God. And as we begin to do that, let us be the example for everyone else. Father, that we may be infectious, Father God, into all of Arizona. Father, and then from Arizona, stretching from state to state to state across the country. And Father, then from country across the world. Lord, we glorify you. Thank you, in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Take two guys, take them.